is involved over the last 5 years, 4 years, and comparing that against the capacity of the school. So you would have this option. Obviously, the only difference is you'd have a little bit more for open boundary enrollment with a enrollment cap, but we're not guaranteeing a spot for as many kids. What if we included Hodgson then? Same exercise, same assumptions, same body of data, using now a growth rate specific for Hodgson. We know, again, these are communities that are 100% built out. And if you look at 16, 17, and 18 projected enrollments for 100%, we're still well within the 900. And it simply becomes a question then, we're balancing, have we gotten as close to that capacity as we can get without being in danger of going over, and accommodated as many kids close to home as possible? And so that would be the other set of theories that we would have to apply to that and see if it meets our standards. And again, I'm talking about all the pieces that we want your feedback on tonight and online. And then I want to show you an option that we've titled as considered. What we won't do is give you an option that's not feasible, because that's not a fair piece of engagement. But we want to assure you that we've considered some of these options. I think we've already seen the challenge with this option just by looking at some of the data. South Terwilliger is the piece that for us is a bit of a it's a bit of a bear. We got about 800 kids right now from that neighborhood. All right? And, 600 under the K to 5, but we are going to end up at 700 or 800 here in the near future. So when you include all of South Terwilliger within the attendance area, we have a bit of an issue that we're handing you a discussion here. We're worried in a couple of years that is not a good scenario. And so we've titled that a considered option, although at this point we're not willing to advance that one because we won't go down that road again with you as stakeholders. Okay? So if we went with a portion of South Terwilliger, what we want to be sure to do is a gain for the west portion, let's say. Make sure that we're accommodating kids as close to home as possible. And so under a scenario that had a portion of South Terwilliger, if that ends up being one of our scenarios, we would work to ensure that when Esther Starkman had the capacity to have the entire portion of West South Terwilliger designated, we would work to ensure that that happened. And we would make that designation. Now, a number of students may already be coming in under a secondary attendance area sort of thing, but we would make that official. And we would work with Principal Kushner. Thank you, Greg, by the way, for hosting tonight, Principal Kushner, to be very clear about when that can happen and facilitate it as soon as possible, and thereby, again, accommodate that close to home as possible component. Okay. Don't give me the clicker again. Hodgson would remain designated at this point to Brander. But again, George H. Luck nearby. Perhaps we can work there and get some of the out of attendance area and some of their enrollment pressures under control. And could we make a nice logical geographic designation with Hodgson at George H. Luck, a little bit better position than up to Brander for a designated school? So we would try and work with components of one or the other plan to ensure that we're still honoring the component of accommodating kids as close to home as possible. I'm going to work now through a scenario or some discussion, more discussion really, on Dr. Margaret-Ann Armour School. Okay, and again, if we're going quickly or whatever, please ask us questions at the breakout. We want to get to that point of discussing with you about the school that you're here to hear about. And Dr. Margaret-Ann Armour, now, Dr. Margaret-Ann Armour is, just like the other one, a full build-out of 900. Now, you know, it could open at 600. These schools are intended to expand and contract. That's the whole concept behind the schools. As communities grow and age and student populations increase, decrease. But our work here is around the ultimate capacity of 900. And in that respect, we've got some designation pieces that I want to walk you through. It's positioned in Ambleside. Again, Ambleside is largely built out. Okay? Right now, it's projected at 900. Currently, if 100% of the kids came out of Ambleside on K-9, there's about 200 being currently accommodated that reside in Ambleside. At 91%, here's another example. All the numbers aren't always underestimates, by the way. We're not going to see, we don't think, 900 kids out of Ambleside. If we're at 200 now and it's 90% built out, you'll still see it rise for a while, but I don't know that the peak is going to be 900. Another variable we're being very careful to track. But if you had Ambleside, Glen Rating Heights, and you rolled them over again, you looked at their average change over the last little while, you applied that. Understand here, it's a little less clear for us though. These communities aren't as built out as McGrath-McTaggart. And you put them together, we could end up with designations that work on a couple levels. Like I said, if it at the ultimate build-out, we've got a lot of room there at 900 for open boundary and enrollment. Don't forget for the Windermere piece, there is a school coming in 2017 to Windermere. Now this Windermere split between north and south, we see about a third of the kids come out of north and about two-thirds out of the south. So we're going to look very closely at Windermere and how to accommodate. Okay, but it's part of our thinking on Ambleside. Keswick, just south, is going to see an awful lot of activity over the next couple of years. All right, it's another body of developers we meet with regularly. Keswick is, and we'll show you some Keswick numbers and that sort of thing coming up. But our fear is, if we were to designate more communities to Dr. Margaret-Ann Armour, there's some challenges. Again, working with projected student generation, you can see that there's some big numbers of K to 9 students expected out of most of these communities. Keswick alone could fill a school like Dr. Margaret-Ann Armour. So we have other asks in, and our capital planning process does not stop. That's a constant piece of advocacy and a constant piece of planning for us that we are have a number of asks in for new schools. So while we have 14 coming over the next couple of years, this body of work of asking for more schools, especially as we get further south in the Windermere area, doesn't stop. Okay, so there are schools approved, and under construction. There's asks coming up. But we're going to have to be very careful about how much we designate to Dr. Margaret-Ann Armour, because any of these are quite large. Always contemplating what we're going to be able to do with Windermere. So while we only present a single option tonight, we want some feedback from you and some thoughts on a manner in which to proceed beyond that, because we're a little bit cautious on our next move there, as far as incorporating a whole other neighborhood. All right, so it's not meant to be a shutdown conversation or exclusive or anything like one option. All we're saying is, please provide us some feedback and thoughts on other approaches. Now don't forget, as I said, under this option, there's gonna be a piece of open boundary and enrollment cap that we can employ and likely accommodate a large number of students from the area, especially as they're not yet built out fully and accommodate a lot of students from the area in that school. Okay, so that's the body of the work What we've done here is just roll up a bit of the data in the form of some comments for you to consider. But for Windermere North and South, what we could do is, again, continue to designate those kids up to McKee and work to ensure that we have to understand what we're going to do with that McKee school when it comes on in 2017. Keswick is designated currently out to the West End, Ormsby there. And that's a curious designation for some people, but don't forget, as the schools fill up, and this is part of our growth accommodation discussion that we would have had with you, as we build this way, the schools fill up this way. So the further out you build, as these schools fill, you have to hopscotch them and go to another school that can accommodate the whole neighborhood. And so they're inverse forces, those. So at some point, it makes more sense, and it did, for a community like Keswick to just not necessarily stick to that south side designation, get on the Henday and run out to Ormsby. And that's worked well from a transportation perspective, is instead of getting too far north within the south side. I mean, we're encroaching, once you're past McKee, you know, and north of Southgate there, we're getting closer to the university than we are in this part of town, right? So we're going to be very cautious with that. But our Keswick designation for that reason is out to Ormsby, okay? And depending on how we do with open boundaries and enrollment at Dr. Margaret-Ann Armour and our future capital ask that will be top priority, sorry, not the top priority, a top priority for us in this part of town, southeast, southwest, always, work to get these capital projects approved and funded by the province. And then Windermere Neighborhood 5, which is not yet named and not yet completely planned, coming on a little bit further down the road. But this end of town, as you know, moves quickly. Large developers, big stages, big communities, and it goes pretty quickly. Okay, so some stuff to think about as you provide us feedback and ask us questions tonight. So we've got a large staff complement here tonight. We will be engaging you. We'll be taking feedback online, collecting a bit tonight, but there's a lot of us. We want to engage in the conversation. We want to get your feedback straight too. So, you know, would really appreciate if you go online, give it to us so that we know that we've captured it accurately and that sort of thing, till October 30th. The superintendent will get a recommendation. We engage all of our principals that are involved. A number of them are here tonight, okay? Also willing to discuss that sort of thing, direct questions to us, any clarifications, okay? But the principals have been engaged. We're engaging communities, speaking with our trustees, and we will get a recommendation of the superintendent here, as I said, hopefully by the end of the calendar year sort of thing. And then we'll work very hard on a communication plan so that we're all clear heading into pre-enrollment. The link, as I said, right here. You can just go to epsb.ca. We've got communication staff at the back. Hi, Jeremy. Jeremy can help you if you need any sort of advice on where to go to access the feedback or the link to my charming dulcet tones this evening on my Britney Spears mic. And share some feedback with us. That's all my pictures for you, but we'd certainly welcome any sort of conversation, questions, that sort of thing, and breakout. So again, down here, Dr. Margaret-Ann Armour, correct?
Yes.
Okay, and upstairs, Nellie Carlson for questions around that attendance area. Thanks very much for your patience and attention.